Yo guys, what's going on? My name is Matthew. Of course, you're watching Megaman Season. Welcome yet to another episode of Photography. Now, I know you're probably all noticing I shaved and I only kind of kept the mustache. I know it looks weird, but you're just I'm gonna shave. But nonetheless, like I said, we are back with another episode of Photography, which hasn't been a thing in like a year and a half. So this is my first shoot really back. And I was pretty excited. I wanted to do a different style of photography. Normally I'm always using these big fancy camera rigs and different lenses and all this really expensive and nice stuff. This time I wanted to take a step back and go quite minimal in a way. And so for that, I decided to do GoPro photography. If you guys remember the last 2 years or so, I've been using a GoPro Hero Plus, a baseline model GoPro that I bought for like 80 bucks off my good buddy. Basically all the Hero Plus can do is you can turn it on and you can hit record and that's it. And then a couple months ago, I ended up getting the GoPro Hero 8 Black, which is a huge upgrade from what I'm used to using. This one has all the features like hyper stabilization and really cool time-lapse features and 4K and all this really cool stuff. And then looking at it, I noticed that there was a photo option, which is something I never really took in consideration with my Hero Plus. And be that as it may, I've never taken a photo with the GoPro before, so I thought, what better way than today? So I ended up packing up all my gear and heading out on the first 90 degree weather day. Okay, so my room is kind of a little bit trashed right now because I'm trying to pack up as much stuff as I can because today's the first day that I'm getting back into photography shoots. So today I'm trying to go big time, pack the Goliath. I'm really excited because today we're mainly focusing on GoPro photography. Ooh,
I like that one. Yes.
Okay, if I'm being completely honest, I completely forgot how far the walk. It is this first location. I wanted to do this location because it was the farthest. Forgetting, it's like 3.5 miles, 4 miles. Oh, shit.
Got my head in the clouds and my feet on another planet. I've been there so many time zones, I can't even understand it this week.
Okay. So, it is really friggin' hot out. I can't curse, I might buy a church. I am still not there yet. I started this adventure off at around 1 o'clock, and also with like 1,000 steps in total. Right now, it is just about 3 o'clock and I have 8,000 steps. It's like 80 degrees, I think it was last time I checked. My camera keeps overheating, so I have to keep stopping. I just stopped quickly to take a rest. And I have to do this whole walk again, going back, just to take one singular photo. Okay. Let's see! Oh, that was it. So my first stop was the abandoned train bridge, to which I haven't actually made a video at in a good while. We used to film there quite often, we used to take photos there. I haven't gone in a little while, so I figured it was a nice day, let me go all the way down there. I'm used to walking every single day 4 miles, 2 to the gym and then 2 back. Was not expecting to walk 8 miles, 4 there, 4 back. Ended up being like 11 miles because I was kind of walking around at the end of it anyways. Oh, that feels so good now that I just stopped and I took off my backpack. Just look how beautiful it is out. I like my college on layaway. I mean, at those prices, I'm on the couch and I'm looking outside. And I've known that I was special long as I've been alive. Okay, so here we are at the bridge. Now it's finally time to take the first photo. Now, I am probably going to try this with both my GoPros, the Hero 8 and the Hero Plus. Living it up before I'm giving it in. It's just water in the cup. Don't care too much for the spins. And there's good people around me, acquaintances of the kin. Now my first thought for this photo is kind of doing like a hanging off, not hanging off, but like legs and stuff kind of dangling off. But this is the first ever time I'm going to take a single photo with the Hero 8. Correction, this is the first ever time I'm going to take a photo with the GoPro ever.
You can call me Jerry Seville, work as hard as a bee, but every time they say
And it did take me a little while to get any kind of usable photos from this. Here is the end result. So again, first time ever using a GoPro as a photography camera. I was not used to it at all. This was kind of like a recommended photo to take from YouTube videos I watched tutorials. My big regret I have with this photo is I edited it in Lightroom first, then I brought it over to Photoshop to try to add more clouds, and because of the color grade and everything about it, it didn't turn out so well. So I didn't have time to kind of reverse it and edit in Photoshop, then bring it back into Lightroom. I will say this is a lot better than some of the other photos I got. They just weren't as good, or I should say this was the best one that I had gotten from those set of photos. So after like 40 minutes of me sitting on the actual bridge to take some photos, I decided to go underneath it, down by the water where people actually go fishing. I ended up remembering about a photo I was going to take during my TikTok photography episode, where this guy put his camera down in the middle of some grass or flowers, and he jumped over it using a self-timer. So I saw a really cool spot and decided to give that a try. Okay, I'm gonna put the camera like right here. I like it because there's all the greenery around me and the sun's peeking in. And I'm gonna do kind of like a jumping over slash stepping on the camera type shot. Now this was way more difficult than I thought it was gonna be because my camera would not connect to my GoPro app at all. It was just being very difficult, so I couldn't see at all what I was shooting. So it made taking this photo be very difficult. I ended up kind of just going at it for like 20 minutes and just kind of using every photo, putting it in the Lightroom and just seeing which one worked best. Okay, got a couple of good ones. I'm gonna now go home, do a last photo, film on the editor, and then we'll take a look. Overall, I will say this was by far my favorite photo from this shoot. It also was kind of one I did the most editing to. There was a huge rock by my feet I had to remove. All the negative space I had to fill with more leaves and more trees. Color grading it turned out way better than I thought it was going to be. I'm really happy and I'm really impressed by this photo. You can see kind of another one I tried doing. I was going to go with this one, but if it wasn't for my actual facial expressions, my sunglasses were half off my face and you could just see my ugly smug, which is never a good thing. With that being said, now I had to plan my third photo, which I had nothing for. On top of that, the biggest storm I had ever seen was slowly rolling in, and I had an hour and a half, 4 mile walk back home. And it kept looking like it was getting worse, getting worse, getting worse, and then even my phone was telling me, oh, severe thunderstorm, severe thunderstorm, severe thunderstorm. So I was kind of panicking, so I just got home as fast as I could, sat in my room, kind of loaded up the photos, and didn't really think about a third photo. Eventually, an hour and a half went by, and I looked out the window, and it was still pretty bad, but there was, like, no rain expected at all, which kind of sucks, because my feet hurt so bad after running 4 miles with 20 pounds on my back. But in the end, I kind of had to brainstorm what I want to do for this final photo, and I kind of looked over at my archery wall, and knew I kind of wanted to do something with archery. Okay, this next photo before the rain starts is I'm gonna put an arrow right in the bullseye and then try to take a shot like from this angle and then have me kind of hold up the bow. I don't know how well it's going to look, but I'm hoping that it's gonna look pretty sick. I'm hoping I can actually get it done before all this shit hits. Okay, I got the GoPro set up on the tripod. I have it connected to my phone right now so I can actually see what I'm shooting. Okay, so I am gonna set up the GoPro in a portrait shot. So this is the shot that I'm getting. Not exactly what I want. I'll try a couple different things. I don't think I have time, but I'm gonna try it again, but like with the trees and whatnot. So let me set it up again. Target one, target two. We got a couple of bricks to hold it down from the wind. We got the arrow coming right through the bullseye, and we got the camera running there. I'm gonna go grab the bow and just see if we can get a little bit better of a shot here. at the end from the way, again, with the GoPro limitations, there wasn't much I could do. I stuck the arrow in the bullseye, took a step back, was kind of doing like a firing pose. I did a couple shots behind my house, but because it's more concrete, I ended up moving to the backyard with trees and grass. And in the end, this was the photo I got. Again, not too happy with it. Just, it was kind of out of my control. I wasn't used to using the camera yet. There's still a lot I have to figure out. I will definitely be trying this photo again, either with my actual camera or even with the GoPro again. But that is gonna be it for this video. And if you like these photos and wanna see more photos from this shoot or any shoot I actually do that's not out on YouTube, then please go check out my Instagram. The link will be down in the description box below. As well as if you enjoyed this video, then please subscribe for more content. Drop us a next video. If you all enjoy, if you have any ideas for photography episodes, leave them down in the description box below. And I love you guys to death, and don't forget, stay green. I can't keep writing songs about the things I left behind. I spent way too much time alone.